Hello everyone. Today we will talk about available solutions when we want to host our project. Let's begin. Hosting. The hosting industry is a big business and has been around for some time. People come to professional hosting companies for different reasons, but they often need help with some aspect of their website's performance. There are many different ways to use hostings, such as email management, domain management, and server management. Some hosts will provide all the services, while others may specialize in one area. To set up a website on hosting, mostly send your website files by file transfer protocol, FTP in short, or by the predefined auto-installer on the hosting vendor. Hosting is very popular and cheap, however, it also has many cons. VPS. VPS or Virtual Private Server is a virtual machine that functions as a private data center. It is an interesting solution for people that need to run different software on the same server. A VPS operates within a self-contained execution environment called a virtual machine, a type of virtualization where an operating system is installed on one physical machine but can be operated as if it were running on its physical computer. It leverages the power of an already existing machine to provide its processing, storage, memory, and other hardware needs. What is the best option for hosting your website? This question has been debated for years, and there is no clear answer since several factors are considered. For example, do you want to manage your own server, or do you want a company to take care of it for you? There are pros and cons to both options that will vary depending on what you're looking for. VPS offers an alternative that may be just the right fit for your needs. This gives more freedom in managing server with root privileges that allow you to install everything you need from the command line, which is very limited or even disabled in the hosting option. This is great for specialistic software that needs specific software in server or cannot be installed by auto-installer and shared hosting. It is also important to note that we need a stable server processor. In shared hosting, we share processor power between all users of that specific hosting. Dedicated server. If our needs grow, we may need a dedicated server that gives more possibility and more power. This is a simple, specific machine just for us. Every business needs a dedicated server. Dedicated servers are the most reliable and secured option for storing and sharing data, but without sufficient hardware and bandwidth, even the best servers can lead to downtime and lost productivity. A dedicated server is a standalone computer that serves other devices on a network. It provides an environment where all of your company's software programs and data can be locally stored, allowing everything to run smoothly without interruption from any other internet-connected device. In dedicated server, we have the biggest control over the server, which give us possibilities such as control backup copy, install DNS or email services, make encryptions and much more. In some cases also access to graphics processing unit. Cloud. Cloud server is a massive collection of servers, each providing storage and processing capacity to the internet. Cloud server is a virtual machine that resides on the internet, not company-owned hardware. As a result, these servers are often more cost-effective, with instances costing less than 2 cents an hour in some cases. This type of server environment is typically accessed through an app or other software and can be easily scaled up to meet peak demands and down to save money when demand is lower. What are the benefits of running a server in the cloud? Since most businesses have huge data resources, they could save money by not purchasing their hardware. Cloud computing also allows for greater scalability, which can be beneficial for companies who are experiencing rapid growth. Cloud computing security is another important aspect to consider, as companies are no longer required to have any physical IT or data center equipment. Examples: DigitalOcean, Amazon Web Service, Microsoft Azure, Google Cloud Platform. Serverless. Serverless is an architecture style that enables building and running applications without managing servers. Serverless is the next big thing in cloud computing. It is a game-changing way to deploy, manage, and scale serverless applications in the cloud without explicitly providing servers, operating systems, or containers. It saves companies money on their infrastructural costs and reduces the time spent managing infrastructure. Developers can now focus their efforts on writing code instead of dealing with infrastructure complexities like capacity planning and server redundancy. Serverless is a great way to streamline your development process. The simplicity of the service makes it easy for less technical people to create powerful applications that are scalable and robust. However, we cut our control and make the project more dependent on a specific solution. Also, serverless is often more expensive than standard cloud solutions with the same server parameters and need to be learned for each vendor. Some solution: AWS Lambda, Acloud Guru, Symfony Cloud. Conclusion. In conclusion, there is little difference between VPS and hosting. This difference is that VPS involves a subscription fee, whereas hosting does not. In addition, the central processing unit of a VPS is more powerful than hosting. Furthermore, what differentiates a VPS from hosting is the software to operate it. A VPS gives us control over operating system, when hosting does not. What solution would you have if you have your social media platform? Let us know in the comments below. Make sure to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more videos like this. Thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.